What up, bitches? Welcome back to the live commentaries. This is the first live commentary that we're recording in 2023. Don't know when this will be released yet, but this is the first one we're recording this year. This is the first one we're recording after our 2022 Christmas special. Fucking thank fuck, I got so tired of goddamn Christmas. So now it's time to get back to the regular live commentaries. And Austin, you realize it's been 2 years now since we started live commentaries.
Stop making me feel old.
You are old, you old raggedy bitch.
I am not, though. I'm only fucking 19. I turned 20 this year. Like, stop.
So, what a absolute banger we're coming back with here, as you already see from the title. Austin, let the good people know what we're kicking off 2023 with. A movie that just came out recently.
Megan.
Mm-hmm.
Or Methregan, because that the actual title of it, instead of an E from with like Megan, it's M3GAN. So, I shit you not, bro.
So, this movie came out a month ago from when we're recording this. We're recording this on February 6th. So, it's been out for a month, and the internet has been raving about this movie. A lot of people saying that this is very bad. And,
bro,
wouldn't you know it, Austin?
This is what...
Wouldn't you know, Austin, it's made by our good friends at Blumhouse.
Oh, I know, because Jason Blum dressed as the fucking doll character for Halloween.
Oh my god, did he really?
Yes,
look
it up.
Oh my fucking god,
look it
why?
Up. Jason Blum Halloween costume 2022, look it up. It's cursed.
God, Jason Blum Halloween costume 2022. Google is loading hella slow right now.
Now, people were so hyped because they're like, oh, he's going to be dressing up as Laurie Strode. He's going to be dressed up as Laurie Strode, and then he dressed up as that.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
I see it now.
Yeah.
Oh my god, this is going to have to go in the fucking sides.
Yeah.
That's how fucking... Should I do the one with the sunglasses or without the sunglasses?
I don't want to know. You know, you pick. Because I.
Oh, God. Oh, it's so cursed.
Yeah.
Oh my god, there's even more cursed pictures coming up.
I don't understand.
Austin, can you put this in the thumbnail?
Sure, I'll put it in the live commentary thumbnail.
No, this picture. You'll have to make it a PNG. Can you put this in the thumbnail?
What are you saying? That has to be the most cursed thing I've ever seen. He looks like fucking... Oh my god, why does he got the pedophile face?
Oh my
bro?
God.
He looks like he's about to fucking, on some fucking Pennywise shit, eat children.
Oh my
god. Nah, bro. Just nah. Why? Oh, this is gonna be bad. This is actually gonna be bad. By the way, the CGI is supposed to be really bad on this, too. Like,
oh,
it looks,
boy.
It's supposed to look really clunky from what I've seen.
Well, this is gonna be our.
And I've seen the trailer like fucking 20 times, dude. I've seen it 20 times because every time I go to the movie fucking theater, every fucking time. Like, I shit you not. Even when I saw fucking Black Panther, bro, I saw Black Panther and this is one of the trailers that came on, bro. Like, this movie is so fucking overhyped already. I'm already pissed. I'm already pissed.
Well, this is our first 2023 movie, so this will be interesting to see. Because this movie's gonna set the standard of what we should expect to see in 2023 movie wise.
This was the first movie released in 2022.
Was it really?
Yes. Oh, January 6th.
Oh no.
So this has really set the standards. I have watched a couple movies from 2023 this year. Alright?
Mm-hmm.
One that I've watched is already on the worst list. This might go above that if it's that fucking bad, bro.
Oh my god. Jesus Christ.
Like I'm already building my worst list, Devin. This year. This is how bad this year has been so far. It's only been a month, bro. It's only been a month.
A month is all you need, Austin.
If you guys are curious what that other movie is, it is House Party from 2023. It's fucking atrocious. This movie might fucking be worse than that. And that's saying something, because that movie was fucking terrible. Let's just fucking get this started. I don't want to be fucking waiting no more. I'm already pissed, bro. You fucking ready?
So, does this movie, like, is it its own thing, or does this movie, like, connect to any other movies that Blumhouse has made? Or are they trying to build, like, their own, like, universe with it?
This, from what I am told, this is their own, its own thing, and it's already got a sequel in the works, I shit you not.
Oh my, it's gonna have a sequel? Why?
It had a sequel in the works even before it was released.
Oh my god.
I shit you not. That's how much faith they have in this bullshit. Why do you think I'm regretting it? Like, why do you think I'm not wanting to watch this? Because this is fucking bad. This is all, I know this is gonna be bad. I know it is. And you know, you could say all you want, oh, have a positive mind, Austin. Have a positive mind. I can't with this fucking company, bro. I fucking can't. Oh. If it's not fucking Jason Blum, it's Jeff Wadlow. And if it's not Jeff Wadlow, it's fucking them ruining the Halloween series. What else are they gonna fucking do, man?
Didn't you send me something on Twitter about, like, Jeff Wadlow making a new movie?
Yeah! Another one!
Wait, what is
it's the almost movie? Like, it's almost like he's made three that were fucking terrible.
Oh my god.
Why don't you give him a fucking fourth?
Because he needs it, Austin.
No, we don't, bro! No! That's just another movie that I have to torture myself with because I've watched another fucking three shitty goddamn attempts at a fucking cinema. Bro, I can't. Oh. Like, I'm already pissed, bro. I'm already pissed. Pissed, dude. Bro. I'm red in the face already, dude. We haven't even started. I can't. That's how much I fucking hate this company, bro. That's how much I fucking hate this company. Are you ready to start this? Do you have any more questions?
I don't really have any more questions, I guess, other than why the fuck was this made?
It's Blumhouse. They give fucking millions to anything, Devin.
Jesus Christ.
They may keep in mind this is the company who made They Slash Them, Truth or Dare, Fantasy Island, Halloween Ends, Paranormal Activity, every single fucking one. The Purge, Devin. This is the people who teamed up with Michael Bay, of all people, and made The Purge.
Damn straight. Austin's favorite films.
Nah.
So would you say Blumhouse is like the worst movie studio?
It's one of the worst, dude. Like, it's
Is
asylum level. It's
That's what
like
I
a
was about
high
to
budget
ask you.
asylum.
I was about to ask you
It's like
what's worse, Asylum or Blumhouse?
asylum is worse only because they're low budget. If asylum was high budget, fuck in like they still made movies like they did, and they went up against like Blumhouse, they would be tied. But Blumhouse is only better because they actually have a couple good movies. A couple, like, legitimate. When I say a couple, I mean like one or two, bro. I'm not even shitting you. And they fucking are a lot higher budget. So I can give them that at least. But even then, they're not much higher budget because the CGI that I've seen from the trailer of this, nah, bro. Just no. Just no. Like, it's not asylum level bad, but it's still bad, bro.
Austin, do you think that Asylum is gonna make a ripoff of Megan?
Probably.
Do you think they're gonna call it?
Probably like fucking.
Fucking Susan.
Fucking, they'll call it Karen to get some clicks.
They already made a Karen movie.
I know. We'll have to watch that eventually.
Jesus Christ, dude.
Thanks. You could thank BTE for that.
Always putting out masterpieces. So this movie is 1 hour and 41 minutes long. So pretty decent length for a film, I might say myself. If you're curious, we're both watching this for free. I don't wanna Well, I mean, I already said it before. We're watching this on Bilibili. Thank you, Bilibili. You guys are goated. But, yeah, fucking.
We did not want to pay $25, bro.
Yeah, to
Like,
rent this on
nah.
YouTube. To rent it, it's $24.99. If you want to buy it, it's like $34.99. Like, what the fuck, bro?
Bro, you can go to AMC Theaters on a Tuesday and fucking see it for $5.
Like, what the
Okay?
fuck, bro?
That's a theater. That's at a fucking theater, bro. I'm not paying. I'm sorry. Just because I'm staying at home, I'm not fucking paying $25 fucking
Not
dollars to
fucking
rent this
paying.
bullshit fucking movie. Like, why? Why would, like, honestly, like, you money-grubbing whores. Like, the
Oh my
fuck,
God.
Universal?
You say you money-grubbing whore.
All right, I'm ready to start this.
Did you start a timer, by the way?
It's been started. It's got 35 minutes left.
God damn, we've been going almost 30 minutes.
Well,
Good.
it's this timer's always for 50 minutes.
Oh, so we've been going almost 20 minutes then.
Yeah.
God damn. Well, I suppose let's get to this fucking travesty now, because it sounds like it's going to be a travesty.
Oh, it's going to. You can't tell me otherwise,
I
dude.
did scroll like halfway through the movie to just make sure that this was the actual movie, and It is, and the part I saw of the movie, it showed the doll, and my God, it looks awful. I will say that.
Yeah, that's the effects of the entire movie, Devin.
No, man. You know it's not a
They
good
were
sign.
proud of this. They were proud of this. They showed it all over the trailers. I shit you not. They're proud of it.
You know it's bad when Austin's screaming before the movie's even started. This is
Because
gonna
I
be.
know this is gonna be bad. This is how we're starting the year, Devin. This is how we're starting the year.
What a way to kick off
I see
2023.
if this is as no, if this is as bad as I think it's gonna be, I know for damn sure that it's gonna stay on the fucking worst list until fucking December. The cutoff date is December 11th, all right? That's the cutoff date, and I know it's gonna fucking stay there on the cutoff date, bro. I fucking know. If this is that fucking bad as I think it's going to be, it's gonna stay on that fucking list for like fucking 12 goddamn months. I know it is. You can't fucking tell me otherwise.
Wait, why is December 11th the cutoff date?
Because I have to have time to gather what I think is the worst and best, and then I edit it all together and stuff before the deadline. For the end of the
Jesus.
year, because I want to release it before the end of the year. So that's why a couple of the movies from last year, like for example, Babylon, Puss in Boots, and like The Whale, for example, all those movies are eligible to be on the list for this year because they came out after
Jesus.
the 11th. So.
Well, let's get into fucking Megan from 2023. Are you ready, Austin?
Yep.
Jesus Christ, who's doing the countdown?
Guess me.
Oh, thanks for taking the helm. I know you love Blumhouse.
I fucking hate Blumhouse, dude. In 3, 2, 1, fuck you, Jason Blum.
Right, it has officially begun, guys. Universal. Turn this down a bit. That way we don't get fucked.
Do you hear mine in the background?
No. Do you hear mine? Oh God, there's the Blumhouse logo. Austin's favorite.
I can hear it like faintly, but not enough to where it's gonna
Oh
be
my
picked up.
God. Did they change? Wait, did Blumhouse change their logo to the fucking Myers house?
Yeah.
Oh God. Atomic Monster.
You know, I'm actually a fan of Atomic Monster. They made the Mortal Kombat movie a couple years back,
It's an
so
Atomic Monster production.
this might change my opinion on
Ew.
them.
In association with Divide and Conquer.
What the fuck is this dog shit?
It's,
What the
I was about to
fuck?
say, is this an ad?
What is that, a fucking Furby?
Perpetual Pets. What?
Ew. What?
What the fuck is happening? I assure you, this is the movie. I checked.
I know I have I'm watching this on Movies HD, so I can confirm. Yeah, I don't.
Imagine they just use this for a fucking advertisement. Perpetual Pets. God.
I actually hate this already.
We're only like 2 minutes in. So, from what Austin tells me, apparently the acting is supposed to be atrocious in this.
At least from the ant character, these are, I think, this is definitely not the ant character. I don't know. Oh, are they gonna pull some shit where they kill off the parents? And it's supposed to be all tragic?
I'm gonna.
Oh, go fuck yourself. They
When did you
are!
say
They
it? When
really
did
are!
you say
Nah!
it?
Nah, they're
The
actually
second
not.
after you
They're
said
actually not! No! There's no way! You can't be that predictable! You can't! No, bro! Come on. Oh my God, I swear to God, if it's gonna be this predictable, if it's gonna be this predictable, I swear to the fucking Lord, dude.
Oh no.
Oh
What the
my,
fuck was
it's so
that?
predictable already! Are you fucking serious? Are you fucking serious? I was joking! I was joking! I was legitimately joking! Really, Blumhouse?
Hit
You've got to be
by.
fucking serious right now. You can't be fucking. Oh my God, you can't be fucking serious. Now we got.
What did they even get hit by?
I don't know, man.
Oh my God.
Bro.
Oh my God. Funky, ew.
That's the ant character, from what I've seen in the trailers.
Oh my fucking God. Oh. The movie's been on for 5 minutes and you've already been screaming your head off. This is not a good sign. Yes, sir.
Bro, you can't, like, you saw what I just saw. After I said that shit, like right after I said that shit.
Legitimately, the second after you said, are they gonna start it with by killing off her parents by some tragedy, and then it happened.
Like, how fucking dumb, dude, and predictable.
What do you think about the acting so far?
What do you think about the acting, Devin?
He said, "What in the name of ever-loving Christ?"
The shit tsunami.
Oh God.
Bro, why? Wait,
What?
hang on. Are you telling me
Oh no.
that this fucking android is supposed to be a children's toy?
Yep. It's supposed to compete with what they were showing on that video, because that was a knockoff of their product. So he wants a new toy for $50, Austin. You get a fucking android.
You're telling me they're fucking making androids to compete with fucking Furbies.
Yep. Oh, it's so bad.
Yeah, fun toy.
Austin, wouldn't you want that as a toy?
No.
Fucking god.
This bitch is giving me David Arquette vibes, and it's pissing me off. She's giving the confused David Arquette face. She's giving the confused David Arquette face.
This makes me think about when you're like, act, David, act. Oh my god. Man, we need to watch some more David Arquette films.
Oh, now here's the fucking one bitch. Their parents died. Haha, your fucking parents died. Cause a fucking cliche!
It's not a cliche, Austin. It's Blumhouse's genius. I like how she only. I like how the fucking girl only got like minor scratches on her face from that accident, but the parents died.
Yeah. Yeah, parents just fucking died.
And she just got a few.
Nah.
She gets a few paper cuts.
Her Furby was okay. It's okay.
Mm-hmm.
She got paper cuts and her Furby was perfectly fine.
Yeah, because they build those toys to last, Austin. See, if you were driving with your Furby collection that you have, and you got in an accident, the Furbies would survive, but you wouldn't. That's how they build those Furbies. By the way, why do you have a Furby collection?
I don't.
Yes, you do. You showed me pictures.
I'm not with. Bro, I'm not even with this movie. Like, don't even fuck with me with this.
Oh, a dog jump scare, Austin.
Wow. What a jump scare. Maybe try cranking your fucking acting up a notch. How about that? How about you fucking act?
Wow, when you look up, Austin, when you look up Megan on Google, it's listed as a 2022 film.
It's 2023, I'm telling you.
It says Megan, PG-13, horror sci-fi, 2022.
Look up the release date.
Release date is 2023, but it's listed as 2022. Yeah, IMDb, Megan 2022. IMDb listed as 2022. So you're wrong, Austin. You're wrong. Apologize to Blumhouse right now.
It doesn't matter if I apologize, because even if it's 2022, it would be fucking late 2022, so it still qualifies if it's going to be on this fucking worst list. And right now, it's fucking teetering.
So I'm pretty sure the aunt character is played by Allison Williams. Yep, that's her. Let's see what else she's been in. Let's go to her
IMDb,
as Austin says.
I'm pretty sure I heard she was like a fucking a
oh gosh, she has 8 awards.
I'm pretty sure she was only hired because of like her fucking family history. I'm pretty sure. Pretty sure like her I think it's her father's like really fucking popular. I don't fucking know. Bro, her parents died. Are you really gonna be that fucking picky about a coaster?
Her last movie before this was Horizon Line in 2020. And before that it was The Perfection 2018. Oh, she was in a TV series called A Series of Unfortunate Events from 2018 to 2019.
I think that had a fucking...
Oh my gosh, she voiced a character in The Simpsons.
Everybody voices a character in The Simpsons, Devin. Like, it's like commonplace at this point.
Oh, Austin, she was in a TV movie from 2014 called Peter Pan Live. She hasn't been in a lot of stuff.
She's I'm pretty most sure like, her known... dad was like...
It says she's most known for her role as Marnie Michaels on the HBO comedy drama series Girls that ran from 2012 to... What does that say? ...2017. Oh, she was also in Get Out, apparently.
So oh, she... my God. She was the worst part of Get Out. I remember this bitch. Nah, I remember this bitch. She was the fucking girlfriend, and she was the worst fucking part of that movie.
I haven't seen Get Out, so like, why was she the worst part?
Because of her acting.
But her acting was so good that she's the main character of this movie, Austin. Blumhouse saw the sheer talent.
Well, I mean, Get Out was made by Blumhouse. Like, Get Out is, like, one of the few fucking good Blumhouse movies. So...
Yeah, so Blumhouse had to capitalize on her.
I mean, they really should have capitalized on the other actor. But, I guess not.
So, it says that Megan has 2 actresses... One is Amy Donald and the other is Jenna Davis.
I know one's a child because I think
they're
I'm pretty
both
sure
children.
They're both children.
Yes.
Oh
Jenna
my god!
Is
I
a
know
child
one
of... and Amy is a child. She. Oh my god!
I'm
she was born
sure
in 2011.
The voice and one's. I'm pretty sure one of them's the voice and one of them's the body. Because I'm pretty sure they just used a child's body that did all the acting, and then they just CG'd a fucking, like, the doll's head onto the actor's body. So the actor...
Know. It doesn't say, it just says
from what
Megan
I saw, the actor had to wear
names.
Green screen, I'm pretty sure. Like, on their face.
God.
Like a green screen mask, bro. And I can only imagine how uncomfortable that is.
People also ask, who was Megan modeled after? Speaking about the design of Megan, the designer stated that he looked to screen icons from the 50s like Audrey Hepburn, Grace Kelly, and Kim Novak for inspiration.
I have no clue who any of those fucking people are.
One of them has the same last name as you. Oh my god. People also ask, is Megan a good movie? Megan is an enjoyable horror light romp. It's amusing, but particularly not scary.
No, please tell me, are you fucking enjoying this? Because I'm not. Are you enjoying this?
I'm enjoying how angry you are.
No, but are you enjoying the movie? Like itself?
No.
Exactly. It's not fucking enjoyable.
People also ask, is Megan the doll a real person? It just brings up the actress. Jesus Christ. But Austin, this here, it says they didn't use CG, Austin. It says they used animatronics and puppetry.
That don't make it look any better.
Oh my God. Someone asked, can my 8-year-old daughter watch Megan 2023? What the fuck? I like how it says people also search for Annabelle Child's Play 2019.
Bro, they're just searching for shit, bro. They're just searching for shit.
Oh my God. Oh God.
Did you really just give the child toast for breakfast?
So also when you look up Megan, you have to actually put M3GAN, that's the title.
I'm so confused on why this fucking character just gave this little girl toast for breakfast. It's just toast.
If you're curious, the director was Gerard Johnstone.
Oh, I've heard of him. He's made nothing but shit.
What else did he make?
We had another, like, low-budget horror movie, and it was god-awful. I can't even remember the fucking name of it.
He made Housebound 2014.
That's the one.
Megan 2022. Sion's Samoan Wedding 2006 and Nothing Special 2005. This is only his fourth movie that he's directed. This is the first movie he's directed since 2014. Why did he not direct any movies for 8 years?
Yeah, the one from 2014 is the one that I've seen. It's god fucking awful.
He's from New Zealand, Austin.
Wow, that makes it's so much more enjoyable. He's from New Zealand? Oh, man. Wow.
Ew, what are those drawings?
I don't know. I don't know what the fuck. When hey, is Austin. The fucking stupid goddamn doll gonna come up or what the fuck ever?
Well, we are.
What were you gonna ask?
Austin, what's the timer at?
Fucking 11 minutes.
Alright, I'm gonna save a clip.
Cool.
I start another one. So what I was gonna say, Austin, is even though this movie came out a month ago, it already has a parent's guide.
Nah, bro. You're shitting me right now.
Wait, this is PG-13. It says the sex and nudity is mild.
I'm sorry?
The suggestive reference in the PG-13 rating refers to a boss asking one of their employees if they've been porn-hubbing in the office. There is no nudity.
I'm sorry, that's... Nah, you can't tell... That's fucking... Nah, bro. Nah, bro. You're actually a fucking embryo. You're actually a fucking embryo. If you think that's... Oh, my God, dude.
The closest thing to nudity at all is a toy pet that has a light-up buttocks, only shown very briefly in an iPad video. A man brags that the Megan toy will kick Hasbro in the dick. That's nudity. That There's a lot of it says moderate violence and gore, but that's just spoiling the kills, so I'm not gonna read that. It's moderate profanity. There's 13 frightening and intense scenes. And s oh God, certificate. Oh no. The fucking ratings. I like how in New Zealand this movie was rated M for mature.
Bro.
In most countries, it's like 16. The lowest one I'm seeing is fucking 13.
I'm so honestly, like,
What?
oh, now they're finally making the fucking android.
So someone asked, why is Megan rated PG-13? Answer: it is a very well-made, albeit violent, movie and focuses on human needs as well as artificial ones. Characters are killed and there are discussions about death, loss, and grief. Can a 12-year-old watch Megan? If your kids really love horror movies and have seen other PG-13 movies, this should be okay for them. Oh my God, is Megan okay for 5-year-olds? Why are people searching this?
Because people are fucking sick in the head, bro. They just want to torture their children.
Can I take my 6-year-old to watch Megan at the movie theater?
Oh my god, it's so bad. It's so bad. It's so bad. It's so bad. Nah. It's so bad. It's so bad. Oh, it's even worse in 4K, bro. It's even worse in 4K. Oh my god. What the fuck, Blumhouse? Why can't you make something good? Oh my god.
They did make something good, Austin. They made Truth or Dare, damn it. Oh my God.
Stop. 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 Why is it moving like that?
Oh, it's so
Why? It
cursed.
looks so cursed, bro. Why have you done this? Why have you done this, Jason Blum? Why have you greenlit this? Why have you greenlit a sequel? Wait, what? Oh, this. Fuck off, bro.
Wait,
Get the
what?
fuck out of here. How the fuck did that even happen? What? What? That makes no fucking sense.
It's
Fuck, get
incredible,
the fuck
Austin.
out of
It's
here, bro.
incredible.
Get the fuck out of here, bro. Get the fuck out of here, bro.
I'm all in. But we're gonna be asking the board to invest in something.
Why are you willing to give children this? Why are you actually okay? You just saw the fucking thing explode yesterday. Like,
wouldn't you want your baby sister to have one of these, Austin?
No! This is fucking nightmare fuel.
It wouldn't be, you're saying having an android running around your house wouldn't be cool, Austin?
That is exactly what I'm saying.
You wouldn't want a creepy animatronic doll walking around your house at night, Austin?
That is exactly what I'm saying. I would not want that. Oh my god! Why is he walking around like that? Nah!
Why would she bring it
home? Why?
Titanium ceramic composite. When would they ever put this much effort into a toy? Do you know how cost effective that is? Like, what parent is gonna be able to afford that?
Bro, this is probably like, dude, to even make profit, this probably has to at least cost like $100,000, bro. You can't tell me it's not. What are they gonna sell it for?
Did they say it was gonna be
$100?
Did they say it was gonna be more or less than a Tesla?
They said less.
Okay, let me see. Let me see how much Teslas are.
Teslas are fucking expensive, bro.
Used ones aren't. Used ones are only like 30 grand. Let's see new Teslas. I mean, still 30 fucking grand is a lot. Okay, new Teslas are like 100 grand. Oh my god.
Yeah, bro, like,
I'm assuming if they meant less than a Tesla, probably not that much less if they gotta put this much effort into the fucking AI.
Yeah, like, stop, bro.
Wouldn't you want an android to tell you to flush the toilet, Austin? Because I know you don't be flushing.
I do be flushing, you dumbass.
She's more than a toy, she's family. Are you Vin Diesel?
I would rather watch a Vin Diesel movie than...
Oh, no. Don't say that, man. They're already planning Fast X to come out soon.
You know, Vin Diesel should have played Megan. How about that? That would have made this better. You could have talked about family while killing people.
I mean, I think wait, would Vin Diesel be like an AI?
Yeah.
I'd love to see a fucking movie where Vin Diesel's like an AI and he goes around murdering people just saying family. That'd be fucking badass. So I'm guessing it's another one of those fucking what's the word I'm looking for? Fucking
like adapting.
No, like what you said at the beginning, how when you're talking about like the parents dying, what did you say that was? That it was a
cliche.
Yeah, cliche. That's the word. This is another cliche where it's like they make this amazing piece of technology, but all of a sudden the technology is way more intelligent than they thought that it was, and now it's gonna turn into a fucking massive problem. That seems like that's gonna be the cliche here.
Act, please. Please do that for me.
I wonder if I'm able to look up how much this movie made. Would it have, like, the box office by now?
It should have a little bit of one.
Megan box office. Oh, God. Okay. This movie... Oh, awesome. This movie... Hold on. Let me look at the budget first. That way I can compare to see if this is a flop or not. So, the budget was... Oh, yeah. It's not a flop. The budget was $12 million.
Great.
And the total gross was $158 million worldwide. You said they are planning a sequel?
It's already confirmed.
Oh, dear God.
They confirmed it before it even came out.
What, are they going to call it Megan 2?
I think they called it something fucking stupid like Megan 2.0 or some shit.
Megan 2.0.
Let me guess, she's gonna kill the dog?
That's what I'm assuming.
I swear to God, if she kills the dog and it's that predictable again.
God damn! The fuck kind of dog would do that, bro? Goddamn, he's going for the goddamn, went for the neck, bro. Went straight for the jugular.
That's
holy
some shit! Basically,
shit,
bro.
God
what the
damn.
Fuck? Oh god!
That dog. She wants the dog to be put down.
Oh no, so she's not gonna kill the dog, she's gonna kill that bitch. Okay. That's how predictable this is gonna be. Or wait, is she gonna kill both? Is that what we're gonna do?
Seattle Police.
You know, how would you fucking sleep? How would you fucking sleep, bro, with that fucking thing right beside you? I'm sorry. There's no way you're sleeping.
I don't know.
Oh, go fuck yourself.
Oh, let me guess, it's fucking simulating the woman's voice.
He's gonna kill the dog. Go fuck yourself. Actually die. Like, stop. Like,
At
why?
least they
Why are
killed
you
it
this
off
fucking
screen.
Like... acting.
Is it
She had
you?
to have taken. Nah, she had to have taken fucking David Arquette's acting class because she's not fucking acting, bro.
We're 40 minutes into this movie, Austin. Got an hour left. Her acting is like, it just makes me think of like a bland piece of bread.
Like, there's so, like, fucking...
Oh my god, I just realized their company name is Funky. Is that supposed to be a play on Funko? How does that make you feel, Austin, since you have a Funko Pop collection?
Angrier. Who is honestly, like... I don't understand why this man thinks that this fucking giant goddamn full-grown android would be a great investment for children to play with. Like, what the fuck?
It's like the fakest crying I've ever seen. Wait, was that her legit crying? 'Cause that was fucking awful.
I think that was her legit crying.
Like, all she did was put
I
her
think
hands
that was...
over, all she did was put her hand over her eyes and went, like, what the AI
I
could probably cry better
her.
than that. She's like, what the fuck? I'm sorry, is this girl supposed to have some kind of like relationship with the aunt character? Because it just seems like her parents died. Oh, now she lives with their aunt, and now she has a android named Megan as her friend. And I seem to have lost the part where I'm supposed to care. Like,
I mean, I feel you on that because I feel the same way here. Wait.
What?
Bro, are you t are is she mimicking her dead mother's voice? Why is she singing? Why is the android singing?
Don't tell me it's gonna be a musical.
Bro, stop.
There's
Stop.
people in the audience are
Stop.
crying.
Stop. I hate life. I really
Come
do.
on, Austin,
Like, I
clap.
can't.
Clap, Austin. So, Austin, were you ever planning to watch this in the theater? Did it ever cross your mind?
God, no. I was not gonna pay for this shit.
Is this a movie that you would have walked out of?
Yes.
A live stream? Oh God, that's gonna fucking date the movie in 20 years. A live stream.
Bro.
Bro, no
What?
computer works that fucking fast, dude. Fucking, if the folder is locked, I'm pretty sure you can't just access it by double clicking it. Like, all he did was double click the locked folder and it said access granted. Like, that's not how that shit works, bro.
What was he even doing? I'm so con I
He
don't
was
even know what he was doing.
downloading the private files for Megan for some reason.
I don't know who has worse acting, the kid or the aunt. I don't know who, genuinely. She looked so concerned.
Well, Austin, we are about halfway through this movie.
There's been no deaths besides a fucking dog and her parents.
So, what's the timer at? Just out of curiosity.
24 minutes.
Right. We're halfway through this movie, and I just don't give a shit about any of the characters at all.
I hope they all die. Bro, I
So
shit you
if
not.
well, Austin, you know the aunt and the fucking kid aren't gonna die. They got plot armor.
Can they
But
please kill the kid and the aunt? Can they please?
if that happened, would you like Megan?
No. She would still be god fucking awful.
Oh my God, fucking acting, bro.
What? No, I'm so lost. We're going to school now?
Bro, that pizza looks like the most disappointing, like, store-bought, like, Dollar General pizza.
Let me go. You know, honestly, I don't even think Megan sounds like the robot.
Like, did they just not test, like, anything with this while they were building it?
Why are all these actors bad? Like, why couldn't you get one that was at least moderately good? Like, honestly. You know, say what you want about Truth or Dare. Say what you want. And I've said a lot about that movie.
Oh no.
But at least Lucy Hale and fucking the one fucking dude were decent actors.
Why do they have a designated toy area? Who brings all those stuffed animals to a fucking soccer game? Or what the fuck ever?
Who brought the giant fucking teddy bear? That's what I'm asking. Wait, hang on.
Why does she have a jar of pickles? That's disgusting.
Why? why are the parents at the school with the children? Huh? God damn! Hang on.
He said, "Fuck off."
I like this character. You know, that kid should have been the main character. He's more likable than fucking Katie. Fuck
so,
Katie. She can't fucking act for shit.
So we're over halfway now. Would you say that just off of what we've seen so far, is this worse than Truth or Dare?
Oh, hell yeah.
You think it's worse?
Oh man, this character is great. Yeah, beat that bitch's ass.
Oh, he's probably gonna die, Austin.
Nah, man, don't kill my favorite character of this movie. Don't do that to me. Man, this character is fucking great.
You obviously tell he's going to be the one to die, though.
But let me have hope, though.
Why? I'm sorry, what kind of adventure thing is this where they let kids go off into these dark-ass, like, foggy woods?
Why is the woods foggy, but then fucking...
What kind of adventure, like, is this supposed to be?
The other... This looks like something from Silent Hill. Hi, Megan. Oh, so you're not gonna play with me? Yeah, why the shoe? You don't wanna play, huh? This fucking character's great, bro. Oh, come on, man.
Is she gonna twist his neck?
Bro.
Oh my god.
They always gotta fucking take out the good characters, man. That's always what happens in these fucking dumbass movies. Like, they can never fucking... They can
Did she
never
rip his
fucking...
ear off?
I believe so. Oh, at least he's running. He's got somewhat of a chance here. What the fuck is she doing? Why is she running on fours? Why is she running on fours? What the fuck?
Oh my goodness.
Aw, bro, come on. This movie's bullshit, man.
As soon as they have a character you like, you fucking dies.
As soon as they have a character I like, man.
I like how the fucking kid was in the road and the driver didn't even choose to stop. They just hit him anyway. A glass of water, that'll help everything. Isn't that what you do when you're upset, Austin? Don't you get a glass of water?
When I'm upset, I get alcohol.
So, where's your alcohol? Because you've been pretty upset this whole movie.
I have work tomorrow. I can't drink.
You always make that excuse, but you know damn well you could drink. She's gonna fucking die, isn't she?
I mean, this movie's that predictable, so I wouldn't be surprised.
Oh, we're an hour in, Austin.
God, we're only an hour in? Oh, bro.
Oh my god, just singing
Why?
again.
Why are we singing again? Why are we singing again? Why?
Because, Austin, we need to.
We don't, though. We just don't, though. Yep, you predicted it.
This movie's predictable.
Yeah. Bro, what? Hang on. She's just going in a random fucking. What? This is trespassing. What the fuck are you doing?
I don't think this woman cares, Austin.
Oh, now she's just breaking and entering now. What the fuck?
I can't see, it's so fucking dark.
Really?
Oh my my god. What the f- is that a pressure washer?
I believe so.
Oh, a nail gun. What the fuck is that? Fuck?
What in she what?
What was that, acid? Wait, so was that acid, or what the fuck was it?
I don't know. Are you trying to make a connection? She looks so concerned.
Mm-hmm. That acting skill. What's the timer at, Austin?
It is at 6 minutes.
Yeah, let me save a clip. Alright, start another one.
Alright.
Oh god. What, saying her files are corrupted now? Why did you ask me if I was okay? You're not programmed to ask me how I feel. I'll see.
Megan. What are you doing?
Couldn't sleep. Occupational hazard. How about you?
What is this supposed to be? Oh, let me turn this down. It's supposed to be a fucking...
Great A acting, you know. Great A acting, you know. I don't want to see this movie no more. I don't. Okay. Please, get in another car accident. Please, for fuck's sake. Can all these characters just die? Can all these characters, like, they're all fucking annoying, they all can't act, I can't. This is, so far, this is the worst movie of 2023. So far. I shit you not.
Well, is Blumhouse releasing any other movies this year?
I believe so.
Maybe it'll have some competitors, Austin.
Grade A acting. Like, grade A. So fucking grade A that it's under A, goddammit. What is Megan? It's shit. It's
Megan
shit.
Megan is the greatest technological advancement since the automobile.
Nah, fuck off, bro.
$10,000!
$10,000! Are you fucking serious? Nah, bro. Nah. Who can afford that? Who can afford that?
Obviously, every parent in the world.
No, man! Nah, fuck off. Fuck off.
Bro, there's fucking sex robots that don't even cost that much. Like, what the fuck? So this is bitch.
Oh my god, shut the fuck up about your parents! They die! Oh my god, that's your whole character! Shut the fuck up! Oh my god. I'm pissed. Hello?
I'm here, I'm just being quiet while you scream. It's okay, awesome. We got like 30 minutes left.
Damn it!
Oh my god. God damn.
You know, this fucking aunt character really sucks as a fucking parent, bro. It makes sense that you're so, like, obsessed with an android, because you fucking sound like one. Like, god damn, your acting is bad.
Awesome, she lost her parents. Did you know that she lost her parents?
Dude!
They keep bringing it up, Austin. They want you to care.
Oh, I don't care, bro. I don't care. It don't make me feel bad. I don't feel bad. I don't.
But she lost her parents, Austin.
Too fucking bad.
He said too fucking bad.
Boo fucking who? Dude.
God. Ugh. Austin, are you red in the face right now?
Yeah.
You, her name is Gemma.
I thought it was Jenna.
He said Gemma. Hold on, let me see if this is what her actual name is in this. It is Gemma. It's G-E-M-M-A. What kind of a fucking name is Gemma? Ew. Oh, God. Oh, Austin, so, you know how the girl's name is Katie? How do you think it's spelled?
K-A-T-I-E?
Nope, you are severely incorrect.
How is it spelled?
C-A-D-Y.
That's fucking stupid.
That's how they spelled it. Yep, Gemma. What kind of a fucking name is that?
Bro, they don't... When a phone hangs up, it doesn't stay on your phone for that long.
Can somebody else die already? There's only, like, almost 20 minutes left. There's only been one death. Like, I'm guessing, are all the deaths gonna be, like, tame because it's PG-13?
Most likely.
But how come the parents' guide said there was moderate blood and gore, Austin?
Bro. Why have you chained up this doll? Like, what the fuck? You know what makes this so much worse? That doll's chained up and shit, but you realize the kid actor had to be chained up and shit like that?
Oh, God.
That's a little fuck, Jason Blum, I'm not gonna lie.
Do you think Jason Blum wanted to see that?
Maybe.
Oh my fucking God.
You're gonna use a hacksaw. I am sorry. Really? Are you...
Are you okay?
Bro. Is that music playing?
Yes.
Bro. What music is playing right now? What the fuck?
I can't. What the fuck is this?
So stupid, bro. Bro. Can I ask why she's got a samurai sword?
So was the fucking the siren only in one part of the fucking place or something?
I guess. What the? Are you? She's gonna drive a Lamborghini. Are you fucking shitting me?
What color is her Bugatti?
Damn it.
Oh my god. Why does she go into her room at the same time every single night? Like, why? Just go to sleep. We got 20 minutes left, Austin.
jump scare, isn't there?
Why is she playing the piano now?
This looks so bad, bro.
He's like, can she just not see that? Like,
God, you are dumber than a fucking bag of dicks, bro. Oh my God. And you just can't fucking hear this either, bro. What the fuck happened there?
I don't know.
Why was there a zoom in shot? Why is she moving? What the fuck?
Oh my God. What
is
the
that
fuck,
shit?
Man?
This is so bad. Oh, now you can hear it. I'm sorry. What? What? That's not how that works.
It is in Blumhouse's universe.
Bro, what in the fuck?
What was that supposed to do?
Oh my fucking... Bro, why do you have a whole fucking mini chainsaw in your fucking room? How is that barely doing shit? It's a fucking chainsaw. How did it get? It got ten. Oh my fucking. Oh. Ew.
Now it's got Austin's hairline.
No, fuck you. Bro. Bro.
Fucking choke slam.
What the fuck?
Oh my fucking god, dude. Oh, this is so bad, bro.
Oh my fuck, bro. Bro. Is it still alive? Mm-hmm. Bro, are you fucking serious right now? Nice one, dumbass.
I like how she couldn't stand up, and now all of a sudden she can stand up.
So you couldn't do that? You couldn't do that earlier! You couldn't do this earlier! Not kill her. Please, let her die. Let both of them die. A screwdriver. I'm sorry? A screwdriver.
Mm-hmm.
Now the get the fuck out.
He said get the fuck out of here.
Oh my god.
Fuck off. Fuck off. Fuck off. Does this have an end credit scene? Does this have a fucking end credit scene before I fucking before you fucking give fuck you Jason Blum, fuck you James Wan, fuck you.
Well, that was Megan from 2023. Does it have an end credit scene?
Check. I'm not fucking checking. I can give two shits. You fucking check.
It does not.
Good, good. Fuck this movie.
What's the timer at before we give our thoughts?
You're gonna have to start another clip.
Alright. Let's get into our thoughts, Austin. Let's see.
Go ahead and go on yours.
Oh, no. Okay. Well, what did I think about Megan, or M3gan, or however the fuck you're supposed to say it? It was bad. This was bad. The acting was bad. The CG was bad. Fucking overall, the story was just really stupid. Like, they gave you absolutely no reason to care about any of the characters. And it just was very, very bad. And, you know, people are hyping this up, and it just seemed kind of just really lame. Like, because I seen people hyping up, they're like, oh, Megan is the new killer doll, and blah, 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 and making it seem like Megan was supposed to be, like, this badass, like, killer doll, and she killed a dog, an old woman, and two other people, and that was it. Like, it's just so... It seemed like they were building her up to go on, like, a massacre or something, and then she just didn't. And she got beat by a little girl with a screwdriver. Like, the fuck was this shit, bro? The fucking... Like, they made her fucking sing and dance and play the piano. Like, what was supposed to be scary about this? Like, and you know, like, people who have a fear of dolls, which you said you used to have a fear of dolls, didn't you, Austin?
Yeah, I used to have pedophobia, which was the fear of dolls.
Yeah,
like, I got over it through therapy, but even then, this wouldn't have fucking scared me. This, like, is fucking stupid.
This is just overall, from beginning to end, very just, it seemed like it was poorly written. Some stuff just seemed like they were trying to make it hip with, like, the technology and talking about live streaming and this and that, and parts of the movie were just boring, where we're just getting, like, scenes of, like, the fucking aunt character and fucking the kid character, and they're, like, doing all this fucking dialogue like we're supposed to give a shit, and they just give you no reason to care. Like, the aunt character is just a cunt, and then the kid character
is also a cunt, and the fucking killer doll is also a cunt, and everybody else in this movie is also a cunt. So, like, you can't give a shit about any of the only person in this movie that was even good was the fucking Brandon character.
He died 5 minutes after he was introduced.
Yeah. So, I don't know. This was just really bad. Would I say it's worse than Truth or Dare and Smile and They/Them and Fantasy Island? In some aspects, yes. I do think Truth or Dare had the dumber fucking story, but fucking this is just bad. Like, man, Blumhouse just continues to put out shit after shit after shit, bro. Oh my god. Like, the last Blumhouse we watched, I believe, was They/Them, right? Was They/Them Blumhouse?
It was Blumhouse, but the last one we actually technically watched was Halloween Ends.
Oh, well, yeah, that's still bad. And then this was also bad. So, but my overall thoughts, this sucked. It was lame. It was boring. And when stuff was actually happening, you had no reason to care, no reason to give a shit about any of the characters. The movie was so overly fucking predictable. Like, my god. Would I ever watch this again? Fuck no. Would I ever own this? Fuck no. And what would I rate it out of 5? This is going in... Do you remember where I put Truth or Dare and They/Them and all that at?
I don't remember. I'm gonna tell you right now, I'm gonna fucking say something that's gonna surprise you.
Oh no. Alright, well, I'm gonna put this... It's not as bad as To Boldly Flee, so I can't put it in purgatory. It's not that bad. But I think I'm going to put this in... I think I'm going to go 12th Circle of Hell. That's where I'm going to put this. This was pretty fucking bad, bro. But yeah, that wraps up my thoughts. Go ahead, Austin. The floor is yours.
Well, I'm going to mention this right now. So this movie came out on January 6th, right?
Mm-hmm.
Cool. We're watching it on February 6th. Uh-huh. And this is the 6th movie I've watched this year.
Oh no, 666.
So there's already a bad sign. Then let's also go and say that this has opened up a new fucking tier. A new fucking tier of bad. So what I am going to present to you is this is going to go in the tier between the Circles of Hell and Purgatory, which I'm going to call Jeff Wadlow.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
Oh my god, Jeff Wadlow's getting his own tier.
His own tier, and this he's not even the director, but Blumhouse has just caused this. I can't call it Blumhouse, because if I called it Blumhouse, I would have to be putting in shit like fucking, like Halloween 2018, which is actually good, alright? So I have to call it Jeff Wadlow.
Wait, so does that mean that Truth or Dare, Fantasy Island, and They/Them are all in this fucking thing? Oh no. What about...
And Smile! Oh, though it's not even Blumhouse.
Oh god.
And this joins all of those fucking movies in there.
Oh my god.
This movie's fucking terrible. It is the worst movie I've watched so far this year. It is worse than House Party. That movie was fucking bad. I've only watched 2 horror movies this year, surprisingly. Mm-hmm. One made me think and was a mindfuck, that being Infinity Pool. And one being completely fucking shit, bro.
Oh my god.
Like, why? Why? No, I would not own this. No, I would not watch it again. This is fucking terrible. And every time I watch a goddamn Blumhouse movie, the bar just gets lowered and lowered and lowered. Every fucking time. This is getting a sequel.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my god, bro.
Oh my goodness.
We still have to do a review. We still have to do a fucking review.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, because Austin's doing a review for his channel. Are you okay, Austin?
I'm angry. This is the first time this year when it comes to a movie that I'm this fucking angry. Constantly. Constantly. Every year. Every fucking year without fail, there's a movie that makes me this fucking angry.
It always seems to be horror movies.
It's the genre.
It usually seems to be Blumhouse as well. In case you wondered, Austin, I looked it up. The Megan sequel is going to be called Megan 2.0, and it's slated for a 2025 release.
Oh, great.
And no. The aunt character and the kid character are returning.
Great, great. You know, honestly...
It's supposed to come out January 17th, 2025 is the slated release date. So we get to kick off 2025 with Megan 2.0.
Honestly, I do not think anything is going to be worse than this year. This might stay as the worst movie I've watched this year.
Here's a quote from Jason Blum. He said, quote, "After I first saw the movie, we had a good sense that a sequel would really work."
Like, I remember seeing the trailers all the way back. Like, legitimately, all the way back when I watched Halloween Ends, and I knew it was going to be bad. Like, I knew it, and I wasn't wrong. I legitimately was not wrong. The fact that I sit there and fucking predicted that it was going to be an atrocity.
Well, from what I've seen, looking up the sequel... A lot of these news sites are calling this a bonkers Halloween movie, a amazing fun horror movie, the internet's favorite demonic dancing doll is what they're calling her. The instantly iconic Blumhouse film Megan.
I'm putting it in that list that I have on that. I can't be bothered, bro. You go to the list. Worst movies I've ever watched.
Oh, it's going on worst movies you've ever watched. Oh, no.
I haven't put anything in here since fucking Hubie Halloween, dude.
Did you put smile in there?
I probably need to, actually. Thank you for reminding me.
The AI doll who became a sensation. People really love Megan and Austin. Blumhouse said they want to fast track a sequel to this movie. So they're fast tracking it, so it's probably gonna be even worse.
Great.
Oh my goodness.
You know, as we keep going, dude, as we just keep going, like, let me just read you this list, bro. It's
oh my god, Holocaust. Austin, this article says $100 million and a sequel in the works. Why has Megan become such a hit and a gay icon? It says Megan has only been in a, okay, hold on. Okay, I'm trying to see why they're saying it's a gay icon.
No. You know what? My sister's a lesbian. Let's fucking see. It is. No, let's live on this fucking live commentary. Let's see how much of a gay icon this fucking character is.
Oh, no. Oh, they're saying because Megan's a female that she's a must want in a rabid gay fan base. Is what this
I need to ask you a question. Since you are gay, all right? Okay. So no. Is Megan a gay icon? Because I genuinely can't be bothered. That's what this article is saying. The fucking movie.
Oh my god.
Yes, the one about the fucking doll.
We're saying freaking Chucky's a freaking thing.
You heard it your fucking self. No, Megan is not a fucking gay icon, you fucking dumbass.
Well, here's an article, Austin. From the gamer, why Megan is a gay icon. Megan is dominating the box office with her killer performance. But how did she slay her way to queer stardom? This article is by Stacy. I saw Megan at the weekend. A movie so good, I'm prepared to break my usual rule of avoiding ugly branded styling. It's not Doom, and it's definitely not Watch Dogs, but it is Megan. And I assume the sequel will be Meg 4N, despite being the second in the series and not the fourth. The reason Megan can get away with this while Doom and Watch Dogs cannot is because Megan does not take itself seriously. Watch Dogs uses the underscore to imply some sort of dark web edge, as if a little line in place of a space is the signifier of a complex computer genius mind at work, rather than something we all did on MSN when we were at school with names like Jenny underscore RAR underscore XD. Megan knows exactly what it is for the gays. As well as silly stylized names, I've always had a little bit of an issue with something being for the gays. As both a queer millennial and someone whose job requires them to be online a lot of the time, I see a lot of queer internet spaces. There are a few factors there. Firstly, everyone uses the internet, including queer people. Secondly, queer people often take sanctuary on the internet to be the fullest and most performative version of themselves. Thirdly, the algorithm tends to funnel me to these communities because I myself am queer. All three of these combine to make everything for the gays. Too often, something that is universal to everyone queer or straight, for example, liking garlic pizza or forgetting your password, is for the gays.
What?
A queer person will post one of these universal experiences and everyone who responds will agree. But thanks to online communities built by the algorithm, everyone who responds is also queer, and thus forgetting your password becomes gay culture.
I'm sorry? This has to be satire.
Megan is for the gays in ways beyond this. Yes, it's a universally appealing movie, the perfect January flick with campy horror and modern laughs over a lot of horror's outdated slapstick or overly cerebral satire, but there is a deeper queer appeal. Writer Alika Cooper suggested in SFX magazine that the reason is because the central plot of adoption, quote, resonates for a lot of people in the gay community. The gay community? I'll stop. The idea of found family, which is a strangely off-the-mark take for someone who has created an actually self-aware film. Oh, this film was self-aware, Austin.
No, it fucking wasn't, bro.
The reason Megan has this queer appeal is twofold. Firstly, she is the sort of well-dressed, immaculately styled, bitchy villain we see deliver punchy burns in our favorite sitcoms. She's Chanel Oberlin. She's Blair Waldorf. She's Regina George. Secondly, secondly, from her blonde wig to her poofy bow to her energetic dance moves, she's basically a killer drag queen.
I'm sorry.
Megan starts with a satirical advert for what is essentially a combination of Furbies and Funko Pops, mixed in with the worrying trend of kids being obsessed with iPads, and immediately nails the tone with TikTok era humor. That never feels like it's trying too hard to be funny. Oh my god. Despite us all being on the premise, it takes a long time for Megan to become the killer doll she's pitched as. And that care to establish her character is what is already a short and breezy 102-minute movie only helps Megan's appeal as a pretty little bitch. It's always encouraging when a movie with no storied IP behind it becomes a breakout hit, especially one so creative in its premise and so cheap to make. Megan is, oddly, for a movie about a killer doll, incredibly heartwarming. Right from the first trailer, which remixed Taylor Swift's It's Nice to Have a Friend, Megan has understood its queer appeal and tapped into what makes this version of such an old trope feel fresh and unique. I hope the inevitable sequel continues to understand its own charm. And that's the end of the... So that's why Megan is a gay icon, Austin, if you couldn't figure that out.
Bro, I asked somebody in my family that is gay, and they said they were lying.
but Austin, Stacy said that she's a queer and that Megan is a gay icon.
Bro, Stacy is such a fucking, like, basic white bitch name, dude. Like,
don't you want to read all your articles on The Gamer, Austin?
No. It sounds like if I read that, I would, like, after I read it, I would just, like, my eyes would be filled with fucking Cheeto dust.
Oh, like, my God. Christ.
How can we fucking get to the review? Cause I'm ready to just get this review done and go to bed. I can't even be bothered, bro.
Well, I don't know if this movie has a theme song or not. I'll just play that Taylor Swift song, I guess.
Sure,
it's
yeah. I don't...
nice to have a friend. That's what they said the trailer song was. Alright. Let's start playing it. So, thank you guys so much for watching this live commentary. This was Megan 2023, the first of the 2023 films that we'll probably be covering this year. But we are about to go do a review of this on Austin's channel, so be sure to go check that out over on Austin's channel. And yeah, this is fucking terrible. Oh my goodness. Anything else you want to say, Austin?
Fuck Warner House Bros.
Oh my god.
Before we do this review, I'm taking a piss. Fucking water.
Well, thank you guys for watching. We will see you in the next live commentary, whatever that's going to be. So, thank you guys for watching, and we'll see you all next time. Go check the review on Austin's channel. Peace!